Last pass.
Let's do 2 minutes so we don't have to do that. I guess that's, all right. That's how I feel like I've had success. getting recruits to do things that could be too dangerous for them. Yeah. Is that if you build the action, you know, linear enough, like A, B, C, D, you get them doing
that.
Then you could get them doing three, four steps down. And you know, do it right off the bat, they'd never, you know, they wouldn't learn anything because they wouldn't be able to put it. But I used to do, you know, basic action, and then it's just basic action A plus basic action B plus basic action
B. Last class?
That's all it is. It's just 10 courses. Go.
Where did it go?
Right. Oh, that's on the shoulder back there.
Okay.
I'm going to appeal to something that I don't know anything about.
Uh-huh.
So you're a little bit fancy experience.
Fifth.
I feel like if I were to tell you to project your defense of it, I feel like you know what that means.
Okay.
So like, okay.
But I think I know what you mean, but not defense is on sacred, right?
Ah, okay, cool, great. Well, I guess I'm the internet. So it's the opposite.
Yeah.
So defenses with the social media are also tight, but generally speaking, it's all pushed out. So right? So this is tiny. This covers the shoulder, right? But this is much bigger.
Yeah.
Right? So the closer the bigger tends to be. Mm-hmm. So typically you kind of push everything out, and you have a very aggressive and forward posture because of it. Mm-hmm. And you keep it like that, whether you're retreating or aggressive.
Okay.
And that tends to shorten the area of tension that you need, and focus it, and so your posture is limited to this space mostly. And the challenge is we're fronting a circular pressure. This is the reason for the reverse. Because the way the feet is addressed to me is to go around. Because then it has to be on.
See, it felt like the whole back always
has to be on.
Halfway to the. It felt like you pulled back about 3 feet.
Yeah.
And that's making you super slow.
Yeah.
So that whole, like, the whole aggressive direction of the being tight, it'll shorten the action and allows you to get to places as fast as you want.
Yeah.
And it's also the reason why I know it's time to grow the way they are.
There were other things
that didn't work. I saw them having that thing on. There's not enough
pressure.
But when they're flying, I'm going to try and start our way through. People do come out and
bring you back.
Yes. Is it come out and come back?
You were at out.
I need the spot. It has to be in.
Which you can't
shoot the other thing to do. You do that with the arms because the hands within the wrist. Yeah. With a little furniture on it, I can.
Yeah.
And it changes the
So a lot of what you get out of Saber is late period British backstrap, right? That's a lot of what Saber is based on. But if you look earlier in the period with the same weapon, you'd be able to try a total set up and get in, their side story.
Do you want to ask one more
name? Yeah, sure, why not? I haven't done that in a while. See my hand last. I fought everybody else tonight, so I don't think my hand
last. And that took my shoulder
away.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, that's one reason I see you doing those exercises.
I mean, also, today's class, just a different test.
That is true.
We're all shoulder for us.
But no way.
I'm fine. I don't know what you're talking about.
Some of the hardest exercises of all of us is just now. These exercises where you're making all the transitions you've made with the footwork.
Yeah.
You're not using your hips. Like, normally you use your hips and your feet to have the energy. But you're just here doing this.
Yeah.
It's just your arm and your shoulder. And it's building up the strength in your arms. It's the same action, but it's the feet that power you.
Yeah. And Jun San, my hands have to be way higher than yours.
That's fair. All right, let's see if I remember how this thing works.
Protecting my back by not getting
I just pulled it right here.
Yeah.
You would have to bend a little bit. Yeah.
Yeah. That's funny. So, yeah.
I know these are tough speeds, right? Isn't that a civilization of like, what's that? Well, this isn't a virtual button? The button exists? It goes down when you press it? In real life?
Well, not insult to the interface designer. The button and the thing that describes the button are about 6 inches apart.
I mean, which is really just poor UI design.
Exactly,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. This hot pot is bullshit. I think it's a better, cutting short is a better holy shit, right? Holy shit is just going there is one thing. Cutting there is better, but not having to do holy shit stuff is best, right? And so you know, just because you see nothing you can't do it doesn't mean it's a good thing, right? Every time stuff like that, that is terrible, but it kind of works. So, you know, if I didn't know any better, you might think it's something that's not bad to do, but it.
So, it's like a lot of ideas.
What?
Yeah, like oh. Yeah. So all I'm trying to say is that there's nothing bad with the full transition. The trick is to get to move the right tempo. Now, the problem with this floor is that it's very, like, anti-movement. It's so slippery.
It's so slippery.
And your hand and your feet want to move together. So if you're doing frontale finesse transitions, and you should be moving, like, you should be running around. Right? And you might feel like you can't do that because the floor is slippery. So that's not necessarily your fault. And it doesn't mean that what you're doing is bad either. Alright?
Yeah.
So I know that's complicating that. It's not probably what you want to hear, but I'm just being honest, right?
Yeah, it's not
I'm sure you can point out.
Yeah.
It's like I don't have not necessarily regret it, but like the front line.
Yeah, So what's the difference between post longer and four and a really aggressive frontale?
A little.
Not much. Just maybe the frontale points and online. So maybe also kind of think about it that way too, right?
Hey,
you can cut it
over.
It's mostly over.
You can cut to it.
All right, the other.
Nope. I'm just Lauren Carroll.
Yeah, oh, I'm borrowing Leander's game for the matches, and then I'm going to give it back.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Me during the tournament. I mean, I do go for hands.
Yeah.
Not like, yeah. But during the tournament, it was, I mean, it's not like you could have hit it, but like, you're not going.
Yeah.
Right? So that's where it's like, this is why I would usually go for the hands. Okay, I'm not going to do that.
Yeah.
Or I'm going to go deeper and then do it. But my hands are in the way as well. Like, I'm going for the body instead.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, what I noticed also is that when we were doing
Kevin, get the crossbow.
The more what?
We're judicious with our fighting. I felt like we weren't.
All right, so Carol, you want
to take risks? Because we're trying to go fast and because we're trying to attack.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't, oh, look, there's a target. I have this target in mind. This is the only one I'm going to go for. And therefore, I'm protecting myself a lot more, waiting for those opportunities for that hit. Even when we got in close quarters, it was still, I kind of didn't move with a hit when I could have been going for other parts.
I feel like hand hits are more so an opportunity taken when someone else makes a mistake. So if the other person makes a mistake, definitely get hand hits. Yeah. I mean, when people try to go for hand hits off the wazoo, it's like they're risking themselves a lot.
Well, and that's about to go for hand hits. There are situations.
Yeah,
like,
and I mean, for me, it's like going up against people. It's just like.
Yeah.
But okay. Well, I've also learned, even with Ito, that a lot of the times what I'm trying to do is get his sword on the line.
And
not get out of center. It's almost always in center. It's always going to try and go through my hands. It's going to take the step back. And then,
I need to get better at beating and attacking. Because often I beat it.
And you kind of hang out there.
The provocation.
Yeah.
But then I hang with the second intention of going B again, but disengaging into the back.
And that's the thing, that hang, with him, he is in on right away.
You, he catches my hands right away whenever I hang.
Yeah.
you get in and you go as soon as possible.
Yeah.
Or if you hang, you step back.
Yeah.
Of his range of
I do this, I often don't get it, but I'm usually able to get up.
It's something that it's like, I need to train my subconscious to actually not to step there.
Yeah, hit enough times in the head and you learn. That's what I've done.
Fighting you for me is more about tactics.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's good for me is like finding ways around certain moves. And he'll do that too. Some people definitely have patterns, and like my partner likes his slurs, so I go underneath a lot, and he's just like, oh crap.
I noticed that you were doing that with one hand,
which is what I was doing to you when you were doing that false edge pendente. But it was going horizontal.
So you can go on there.
I was talking with Carol.
Oh, just once.
What I realized is that I realized that that's what my back
is. I can see your feet. That's the more
right. Oh, yeah, that'll do that.
Is that this was different because of the back.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, that's why. I couldn't figure out why my measure was so different. I was like, why is it my crosses are good? And I just realized that I'm just like, oh, my crosses aren't out here. My crosses are back here. And all of a sudden, that person is much closer to me. Because if you judge by where the sword is, as opposed to where your body is, and you realize that your sword is closer to your body, and you're no longer in the same measure that you should be.
Absolutely.
This is safe. This is not safe.
So that's another thing my cousin does. They like to tick back and forth, almost pivoting their torso.
Okay, so that is a move, though?
Yeah. No, but unintentionally. But it's not even rocking that way. It's like rocking this way without the footwork.
Oh, no.
It's really bad for the back.
Because the rocking thing allows you to...
Yeah.
You know where their weight is.
Oh, so, no. What you're talking about is that...
No, rocking back and forth like this with the footwork.
You do the footwork, and what the person doesn't realize is that you move closer.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're rocking.
Yeah, similar thing. Yeah, it's a similar concept to this while you distract them.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Or, yeah.
Something I used to like to do in Olympic fencing is stomping. But the stomp is, they think it's distracting them, but that's the other goal. The other goal is like, get your foot closer without them looking.
It is a provocation.
And it's another thing, it looks like a lunge, the beginning of a lunge.
Yes,
that little step is like, so it's called Gillespie, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you do the motion for the lunge, but you're only actually moving a step.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Last pass.
Anyway, we gotta go. I gotta go.
Absolutely.
Are you leaving too?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'll leave
it over. I definitely got myself a little bit too tired earlier because of my, for some reason,
I attacked too much. So,
I know, but it was just like, yes, but this is
okay, because I'm all far away.
Don't attack nonstop, you're going to get tired.
Your finger like
it's time to
archers at the end of the rest of the ring,
but
it's just
a fine. I know if they're falling apart,
coming up!
I've learned my lesson.
If you want something to do that, probably was, because she was thinking of trying to make some of those.
Alright,
so
okay.
Take care.
Okay, so I was talking to her about those.
Okay.
Well, yeah, you have your normal.
See, the funny thing is like, I know exactly how much impetus people can put into their class on this floor without slipping. So.
Orgy here on the weekend.
Sure. Can I give it back to you?
Sure.
Okay. You think you're going to have a problem?
I'd rather not.
Well, then, now you've breached an impossible breach.
It was detectable from the smell when I got in here, but...
Oh, I'm so sorry!
Very comfortably able to dissociate that piece of information.
Oh, no. That's gross. That's disgusting. Fucking hideous. Yeah, one of those things kind of sucks everyone in,
yeah.
Along.
Well, the thing is, like, when my back, actually,
that was because I had the risk and my back, same thing, where it was just not quite up to standard. Maybe I just need to start wearing the brace again so that I've got that extra support.
Yeah, or maybe he's going to go like half the class or something, if it's easy to take on.
Oh, really easy to take on. It's just the Velcro.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, then maybe try wearing it for half the class and see
if
they
can see it. I don't think as much needed for the class as I did for the writing. That's where I found that it was just like because.
Would it fit over gams and under gams?
Under. I don't think it would fit over the gams. It's pretty tight.
Would a belt help at all? Right? You have a belt?
You have a belt. I don't know.
I have a belt.
Yeah.
I have to pay attention a lot when I'm dealing with compensations or overcompensations.
I'll take any of them. I'm just trying to figure out where my board is. Like, it's really
really yeah. tiny
I
one.
I will either
and that's
sell
not it, that's
or
someone else. This box, have this one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, a lot of times.
Sure. You see everybody's name?
Sam,
on
yeah, yeah.
Who's
somewhere
in
seminar thing, and there's figuring out how to get my card working on that run.
Oh, there
were two.
Okay, I have an answer to you with that. I'll quote, full quote. All right,
yes.
Oh,
did
you bring the dabs?
Yeah.
Oh,
drink the dab. Drink the dab. It's the opposite of bad.
It's the opposite of bad. That's great.
Oh,
thanks.
So yeah, I'm assuming somebody has raised an objection, which
no,
I was going to ask.
Well, let me pause.